Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to Palantir's technical analysis for July 24th, 2023. So if you look at the RSI for the one day, the RSI is 55 right now, and it seems to be pointing towards a downwards direction. And there are also other evidences that I'll talk about in the 1 hour that tells me that we are possibly heading towards a more bearish momentum right now. Not to be a buy in the stock, of course, I want to buy more. So there is a NASDAQ rebalancing happening today. And you know what happens to the other stock might cause Palantir to go in the same direction, right? So if we see a sell-off in a lot of the NASDAQ stocks, it's possible investors will get spooked and sort of sell off Palantir as well. Maybe they think that there might be a market crash or something, but I really don't think so. I think a rebalancing is all that there is. So if you look at the MACD for the one day, that it is slightly in the red right now, and I would wager a guess that it would continue to go further into the red now if Palantir can sort of make a divergence from the MACD, then that would be awesome. But I don't really think that would be the case. Once again, my price target for Palantir is $20, so anything under that I would say is a great buy. So let's look at the 1 hour right now. Once again, if you want to see the past 5 days, you can look at my technical recap video. So I'm going to go through the most recent one, Friday, and today's pre-market. We are seeing sort of a consolidation here. And, you know, we once again, consolidations usually follow the momentum before the consolidation. So before that, we saw a downtrend. So unfortunately, it's possible that this downtrend could continue. If you look at the MACD, we are, you know, in the green right now, but there doesn't seem to be a lot of momentum. Obviously, that could change once the market opens and there is a lot more volume, then, you know, that can confirm or deny my suspicions. So if you look at the past, when the MACD was also in a similar state, it failed to break out. So it continued going into the red, right? So I'm suspecting that that would happen once again. And what levels am I looking at? I'm possibly buying at 1554. I did say in my I think it was Friday's video that 1628 might be possible, and that seemed to have been hit. But now that I'm looking at the technicals again, I would not buy it here. But you know, if you are DCAing, then that's fine, right? The RSI is also pointing towards a downwards direction. Now it is nearing that oversold range, but you know, with parabolic stocks like that, it could continue going down even if it's oversold. So that wouldn't necessarily be the best indicator I would rely on right now, but you know, it still has some credence towards the direction. So if you look at the 1 minute right now, it seems to be pretty volatile. There is one support level here at 1640, which I would be extremely surprised if this support holds because of the volatility. So we saw a huge red candle here, but it seems to have been an institution's buying up the stock in the first minute, and then maybe another institution's or the same institution sells the stock. This could be an attempt to maybe manipulate the technicals or something. I'm not sure. Then we see sort of a lot of volatility here, which is just going up and down. And there is a sell-off here, so that created the double bottom here, and right now we are once again selling off. I did miss one thing. I missed this twice, so I'm gonna go back instead of re-recording this video. So back to the 1 hour, the 20 MAs is nearing that 200 MAs, so this is why I actually think that this consolidation will not hold and will not go towards the upside, because once that 20 MA crosses that 200, we are probably going to see a more down trend of Palantir here. So that's why I think Palantir might hit towards a lower price. So, with that being said, just to recap, this is the Fibonacci here. And, I do have a suspicion that we might see a full retracement here back towards 1459, especially if that earnings is bad. But you know, my price target is 20. I'm gonna say it again, and you know, anything under that is, I would say, a good buy. So as always, guys, thanks for watching and have a nice day. Oh, like and subscribe.